Hi, I'm Nash Kraemer, and this is my scenario video. My video is about taking a few original hockey rules and adjusting them to make them safer and allow players to do more without getting called for a penalty. I chose this kind of project because I've been playing hockey for years and I hate getting injured due to players doing reckless things. But on the other hand, I want us as players to be able to do more without getting called for penalties. Well, I hope you enjoy my video. Off to the rink. But before we go, I must explain my first rule. That first rule is, high sticking is allowed, but if the puck is carried in the air for an extensive amount of time, it will be called. Also, if on the way down the stick makes contact with another player, it will be called as a penalty. Here's an example. But if this upcoming clip occurs when the play is happening, then a penalty is called. Stop till we're legends. Here we go. Second rule is, if a player purposely makes contact with someone's body, waist and below, it will not be called as a penalty. But if it is rough anywhere in the body, it will be called as a penalty. Here's an example of this rule in action. It's my turn to make history. My third rule is, if any player attempts to start a fight in a junior game, it will be an automatic ejection. And if the player hurts another player during the attempt to start a fight, it will be an automatic ejection and a 2-game suspension. My fourth rule is, if any unsportsmanlike conduct is made to referees by players, it's an automatic ejection. And if any coach does the same, it will first be a warning, then it will be an ejection. My final rule is, if any player gets 3 minor penalties in a single game, it's an ejection. Thank you for watching my video. I hope this made an impact on how you will think about hockey rules and guidelines. If you have any questions, I will now answer them. Again, thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed. Bye!